Hello everyone. So moving on to today, that is 27th current affairs, 27th November current affairs. Basically, you are having four major topics. First one is with regards to LCA Tejas. Second one is coral reef and coral bleaching. Third one is dairy development schemes. And the fourth one is with regards to National Cadet Corps, that is NCC. The first one, that is LCA Tejas, has been dealt in previous session, so we are not covering it here. Moving on to the second one, that is with regards to coral reef and coral bleaching. Understand that why it is in news, it is because the corals that has been bred in one particular area has been successfully transplanted into another area where it is in Great Barrier Reef. This experiment was successful in the Great Barrier Reef. So here what you need to focus is where Great Barrier Reef is and also what coral reefs are. So coral reefs are diverse underwater ecosystems that are held together by calcium carbonate structures that are secreted by the corals. And in fact, these reefs, they grow best in the warm, shallow, clear, sunny and agitated waters, which is actually available or the most apt area is at tropical as well as subtropical waters. That is, these algae, the symbiotic algae named zooxanthellae algae actually requires requires sunlight, which is available in this tropical and subtropical waters, as well as requires a temperature that is between 22 degrees Celsius to 29 degrees Celsius. So these conditions are fulfilled in this tropical as well as subtropical areas or subtropical waters. So that is a major reason why coral reefs are found or many of the are actually located in this tropical and subtropical waters. Now it is also called as coral reefs of the sea. Now here you also need to focus about what exactly Great Barrier Reefs are. Great Barrier Reefs is the world's largest coral reef system that is composed of 2,900 individual individual reefs and also 900 islands that stretch over 2,300 kilometers. It is located in Australia, so you need to understand where exactly these reefs are, the area where these reefs are spread over. In fact, it can also be viewed from outer space. So it has declined by more than half in the last 30 years, and that is the reason why there was an international effort towards restoring their growth or restoring these coral reefs. So there were two major two popular approaches. The first one was with regards to is with the coral gardening approach, which is a traditional method. Here healthy coral is being broken, and actually this is transplanted onto the damaged coral reefs with the hope that it will regrow and thereby help in regrowing the entire coral reef. So it is not that much successful, while the next one is with regards to larval restoration approach that has been adopted in this particular case. So in this, the eggs from the corals are collected and then they are transplanted or they are actually allowed to grow into larvae stage, and then they are retransplanted into this area, that is in the damaged area, so that they actually have the capacity to grow back. So this has been successful when you compare with the traditional method. So understand these two major methods and also where this Great Barrier Reefs are and also what is exactly the coral reefs all about. So this is a potential area for your prelims. Details have been given in the material, please go through it. And the next one is with regards to dairy development schemes. Why? Because we recently celebrated our National Milk Day. India continues to be the largest producer of milk in the world. And also in this occasion, the Union Agriculture Minister had explained in detail about the government measures to foster the dairy sector. So here you need to focus explicitly about the measures that he has spoken about. That is, with regards to Rashtriya Gokul Mission, it is towards development and conservation of indigenous breeds. Now, with regards to Gokul Gram, that is integrated indigenous cattle centers, he also spoke about National Mission on Bovine Productivity, that is aimed towards enhancing the milk production as well as productivity. And he also spoke about Dairy Processing and Infrastructure Development Fund, that is DIDF, which has an outlay of more than 10,000 crores. So that is also an important area. National Program for Bovine Breeding, that is for enhancing the productivity of milch animals through artificial insemination. This is also an important scheme. Next one is with regards to National Kamdhenu Breeding Centers, Gopal Ratna Awards, Kamdhenu Awards. So these are some of the areas that you need to focus. It is given in the material, please go through it. And please focus on these individual topics, that is individual schemes, as far as your preparations are concerned. Now, the last one is with regards to National Cadet Corps. That is, why it is in use? It is because NCC recently celebrated its 69th Raising Day. It is the largest uniformed youth organization in the world. It was formed in Germany in 1668, and the Indian version, that is Indian Military Cadet Corps, is headquartered in New Delhi. At national level, please keep that in mind, that is in national level, it is Ministry of Defense that deals with NCC, while at the state level, it is the Ministry of Education that deals with NCC. The motto of NCC is Ekta or Anshasan, that is unity and discipline. Details have been given in your material, please go through it. So, that's all about 27 current affairs. Thank you.